Hey guys, welcome back. The final part on my I Love Kit F-22 Raptor build. So just going to finish off last few pieces and then do a final reveal. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so welcome back to the final part. A few more things to do to wrap this up and we can call this one done. So as you can see here, we've got the jet. Second here we left it off. All weathered up and obviously painted weathered and good to go. But the problem is, underneath here, there are tons of weapons bay. Four weapons bays, two main gear bays, and a nose gear bay, which all need doors, basically. So a lot of work there to do. So let me move this outside and show you, first of all, number 12. So the main doors here, the main weapons bays, there's basically one on each side. It's basically B10, B9, and B23 for the... It's actually going to be the port side because obviously upside down. So here it is. Now it's a little tricky. It took me a few minutes to figure this out in the instructions. So the instructions aren't that clear. So basically B9, the small, thin, skinny part, goes on this side, which is the flat part with no kind of the outside part basically. The inside with all kind of like the ribbing. That kind of, this part here, which is B23, kind of goes on that outside angle, kind of glues on. You guys see that one. So that's how I got that door together. Now, things note, be very careful because when I show you the other side, which I've not cut off yet, there's a million different attachment points and stuff here you need to clean up. So what we've got to be careful is when you cut these, some of these actually have, attachment points, you don't want to cut those off. So if you look kind of, I'm not sure you can see this on camera at all, but when you kind of look down the sprue, you can see some of these have attachment points and some are just straightforward, just like extra ejection mark point attachments. So you could be very careful when you cut these off, you don't cut the wrong thing off. So just be careful cutting these. And then see there's tons on each one and some cleanup required. So that's those. The other doors, I've simply just primed these in this surface of 1500 black on the sprues. Now the reason I primed the door on the sprues is just so I keep track of everything. There's so many, make sure I get the right size. So many parts that look very similar, different part numbers, lefts and rights. It's a lot easier for me to paint all these up on here. And then, see, I trim them off, sand them all down, just leave one attachment point on each one. So I basically paint them all on here. And then as I go to attach them to the aircraft, I can just cut one off at a time and see exactly what number it is and where it goes. It just makes the whole thing a lot easier to manage to build that way. Is what I find, rather than putting them all on crocodile clips and paint them all individually. It's just easier to paint them on sprue, I find. So all that stuff needs to be painted up. And finally, I've got the sample of one of them, the exhausts, nozzles, well, I guess they're flaps, whatever you call them, at the back. For the exhaust, needs to be burnt iron. So I've primed these up also. And inside each one, the Sharpie, I've written a number, so I know which one's which. And if I go back in my instructions here, you see I've written my instructions 1, 2, and further on it has 3 and 4. And on the inside here, you see this one's number 1. You're not going to see on the camera, but see it's written inside there. So I know exactly which one it is. Again, help with the management of the build, make things a little bit easier. So that's kind of where I'm at. So quick overview, I've basically got that to do. I've got the seat still to paint, not going to be too much work. Here it is, the Aries seat. I think, was it Aries? I think it was aftermarket. Could be quick boost. Actually, you know what? It's Wolfpack. After all, so it's Wolfpack resin seat. We're going to paint that up. Won't be too difficult because the whole thing's black anyway. Just a couple of straps and a seat cushion to paint with that and a little dry brushing. So we've got seat to do. We've got all what I just mentioned and also the ordnance. I think we've got a couple of J-dams, AMRAMs, and a couple of sidewinders. So yeah, enough, a lot of work still to do, but we'll get all this put together and get trucking on this one. So yeah, let me get painting and I'll be right back. All right, so quick little update. Some problems, and some big problems to kind of tell you about if you're following along. Firstly, no problem at all with these guys, which were the exhaust nozzles back here. Just painted with LP54, which is dark iron. And then just my usual Alclad jet exhaust, just misted on the ends to create a little bit of color variation. But no problem at all. The problem is with the gear. So remember how we did all, I don't remember if I talked about it or not early on, but I built it all separately. Problem is, I couldn't get them in afterwards. I had to really hack away at some of this stuff and really kind of force to get it in there. So you've got to put these in as you build the wheelbase back there in stage number four. Before you sandwich it together, you got to build the gear, the main gear. Now you can obviously leave the tires off and paint them separately and just add them on the end, but you've got these struts, you've got to do it. You see there's all kind of hacks and stuff and breakages I had. Those gear I kind of got in, again, it's real tough. So my recommendation is follow the instructions, and with this one, get these struts put in and glued at the very beginning, and then unfortunately it makes a little bit of pain painting. And then at the very end, you can have, you know, add the tires on maybe and the wheels. But yeah, the gear has to be done because it just doesn't fit otherwise. It's just too much of a tight fit. So I had to kind of cut and break parts and to kind of get them in and glue back on again. But we do have it on and it is standing nonetheless. But like I said, just make sure you do those early on and not leave it at the end like I do. So I build these things. Purpose of these videos is to show other people and you can learn from my mistakes. So not only did I screw the intakes up, but I screwed the gear up. Also, it's pretty stable, but it's a little bit of a no-tail sitter. So I believe I did add a little bit of weight in the front there, which has saved me. I think you definitely add some nose weight to this, because I think you might, a lot of weight back here, and you might have a problem. So I'm okay. It's standing pretty firmly, but I think definitely add nose weight. And again, put that gear in early on, unfortunately, in the build, and don't leave it to the end like I did. Okay, so if I flip her upside down here, you'll see all the doors are on. Yeah, super glued on, no real problem there. And yeah, good. So now we're left with the ordnance. And basically, well, we've got seat as well, obviously, but ordnance, basically a sidewinder in each of the outer weapons bays here. So two sidewinders, then we're going with two JDAMs and two AMRAMs. In the main weapons bay right here. So six to build, so I'll get cracking with that. And then once we're done, this thing's gonna be finished. So we'll go straight forward to a final reveal. We're done. So finished. Not a bad build at all. Actually went together pretty well as all HobbyBoss kits go. I can't keep calling it HobbyBoss because it says I love kit, but it's HobbyBoss. I don't want to keep having these different branding things. But yeah, went together no problem at all. If you follow the instructions. So a couple of things I went off-piste and ruined a little bit, which you can learn by my mistakes, were the intakes. If you go back to part number two, I think it was, I thought I could just put the intakes on, sandwich the fuselage halves together and put those intakes on and no problem at all. Yeah, I think you should follow instructions, actually glue them on first and then sandwich it and get it all lined up. I messed that one up, so I had to fix that issue. Second one, again, not following instructions. As most modern jets, I do the gear separately and attach it at the very end, which I went to do with this one and doesn't work. The main gear, you've got to build it in. You don't have to necessarily add the tire, but at least build the framing in, per the instructions before you sandwich this thing together. Because at the end, it was too tight, it wouldn't fit, so I had to kind of hack it apart and kind of get it in there. Nose wheel too was a little tricky to get in. I got it in no problem at all in the end, but again, those struts you probably want to put in, follow the instructions, you should be fine. But other than that, it's a really nicely fitting kit. The fuselage halves fit together really well. If you follow those instructions like I didn't, then you'd have no problems at all. So yeah, it's nice. I was worried it'd be a little too plain, but then I looked at those reference pictures and saw these guys get weathered up, and that gave me a little bit of inspiration. So paint, followed HobbyBoss's paint guide and really kind of liked how it turned out. You see parts how I painted it, and once you see at the very end I put some photographs up outside as well so you can see it. So using their method of the Raptor colors was extremely difficult to kind of capture, so I followed their mixing basically super metallics with gray, and it does definitely give the sheen. So I did put a clear coat on it. Over my decals I sprayed that metallizer sealer from Testers, and left the rest no clear coat at all, and you still have that sheen, so the light catches it. You know what you can see right now, but if the light catches it, you can still see that kind of sheen and kind of shine. So that was the first part of that. The canopy's just loose here. And talk about canopy, that's the next one. My kind of came up with an idea of getting this thing kind of metallic
tinted, and it worked pretty good. So again, using what they use, they use Alclad transparent yellow, which is really nice to spray for tinting, and a drop of, well, I did have gold, so I had a drop of brass, I think, to get that metallic. Again, hooked a light, you can see, and you can still see through it, but just gives that metallic sheen. Again, really hard to replicate. So I came up with that one. So I think that was a winner as well. So overall, I'm kind of happy how it's more of a test bed for me. I never built one of these like latest generation fighter jets, and it all turned out pretty good in the end. So yeah, it's good. Would I build another one? Probably not. It's not really my speed, but I enjoyed building this one. All new experiences for me, the colors, tinting the canopy, that metallic sheen, all that kind of stuff, learning new skills. And yeah, we're finished. So just a quick kind of brief kind of build series. I know some of mine have gone on a long time. I did say a couple months ago I wouldn't do any build series, but when I saw this came out and nobody else had done anything on it, I thought, you know, why not? So not my usual one. Like, I didn't get into like weathering, like how I do different steps. I talked more about products because I've talked about it so many times before in the past. Like all my other build videos, you see me put a wash on, you see me do neat oils, that kind of stuff. So just a really replication of that. So yeah, we're done. So thank you for watching and following along on this little mini build series, and if you're new to the channel, welcome, and stand by for more cool stuff hopefully coming up in the future. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye.